Hello there, everybody, and welcome to another edition of our preschool winter concept story time. Today, if you haven't guessed, we are going to be talking about Groundhog Day, because today is Wednesday, February 2nd, and today is Groundhog Day. And what that means is today is the day that we pull our little groundhog friend Punxsutawney Phil out of his burrow, and we see if he sees his shadow. And if he sees his shadow, that means that we are going to have 6 more weeks of winter. So our groundhog did see his shadow today, and so that means 6 more weeks of winter. If you are a winter loving person, then that means you're gonna have a lot more snow, a lot more winter fun like sledding and skiing. If you're not a winter loving person, then you should hunker down with a good book for the next 6 weeks. So today we're gonna be reading a couple of stories about Groundhog Day. First, I'm gonna show you the things that come in your Take and Make kit if you get one of our kits. So you're gonna get our little sheet here, and it's gonna have instructions for your groundhog craft, which is a groundhog who can see his shadow. And you're also going to get in your kit, you're going to get finish the pattern worksheet. You're gonna get a Groundhog Day maze, and you're also going to get a groundhog matching game where you have to match the groundhog to his shadow. Before we read our stories, we're gonna start off with our special song that we start all of our story times off with, which is The More We Get Together by Raffi. That was a tongue twister. Try saying that one a bunch of times fast. So before we start, we're gonna do our signs for our song. So for The More, we do this with our hands. And together we make 2 fists and stick up our thumbs, and we kind of just move them around like that. For Happy, we just rub our shoulders. And then the one that I always say is my favorite, which is Friends, where you get 1 friend, 2 friends, and then they give each other a little gentle hug. So I'm gonna play the song The More We Get Together by Raffi, and this is being played with permission from Raffi. And I hope that you guys will sing along with me.
The more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. 'Cause your friends are my friends, and my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be. Oh, the more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. There's Chris and Tanya and Jason and Justin. The more we get together, the happier we'll be.
I'll sing it nice and loud
okay,
at home if
you
can,
ready
okay?
To sing now? The more we get together, 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 the more we get together, the happier we'll be. 'Cause your friends are my friends, and my friends are your friends. The more we get together, the happier we'll be.
Job, friends. I hope that you guys were able to sing along with me. All right, so we only have 2 stories today. It was a little hard to find good groundhog stories, but the first one we're going to read is called Go to Sleep, Groundhog. And this book is written by Judy Cox. It's illustrated by Paul Mizell, and it's being read with permission from Holiday House Publishers. And does anybody know what groundhogs do during the winter? Do they stay awake all winter, or do they go to sleep in the winter? We'll have to read and find out. Groundhog went to bed on Columbus Day just like he always did. He brushed his teeth. He put on his jammies. He set his clock for February 2nd, which is today. Then he curled up in his warm, cozy bed. He closed his eyes. He tossed and turned, but he couldn't get to sleep. Finally, he got out of bed. He peered at his clock. 1:30 October. Groundhog poked his nose outside his burrow. The moon was full. I'll just go for a little walk, he said. Maybe that will make me sleepy. Groundhog went outside. He saw things he'd never seen before. Raggedy scarecrows and grinning jack-o'-lanterns. Children dressed up like pirates and cowboys and princesses. Halloween witch flew down. What are you doing up, she said. It's almost winter. You should be in bed. Witch flew groundhog home on her broomstick. She tucked him in. She read him a ghost story. She gave him a glass of apple cider. Groundhog curled up in his warm, cozy bed. He closed his eyes and he tossed and turned. but he couldn't get to sleep. Finally, he got out of bed. He peered at his clock. 1:30 November. He poked his nose outside his burrow. The leaves were red and yellow. "I'll just go for a little walk," he said. "Maybe that will make me sleepy." Groundhog went outside. He saw things he'd never seen before. Tall yellow corn shucks and round orange pumpkins. Turkeys gobbling in the backyard. "What are you doing up?" Turkey said. "It's almost winter. You should be in bed and I should be making myself scarce." Turkey took Groundhog home. He tucked him in. He read him a story about penguins. He gave him a slice of pumpkin pie. Oh, again, Groundhog curled up in his warm, cozy bed. He closed his eyes. He tossed and he turned, but he couldn't get to sleep. Finally, he got out of bed. He peered at his clock. 1:30 December. Groundhog poked his nose outside his burrow. Stars twinkled overhead. "I'll just go for a little walk," he said. "Maybe that will make me sleepy." Groundhog went outside. He saw things he'd never seen before. Colored lights glowing on some houses, candles shining in windows, holly wreaths hanging on doors. He heard sleigh bells chiming in the air. "Look who we have." Santa flew down in his sleigh. "What are you doing up?" he said. "It's winter. You should be in bed." Santa took Groundhog home in his sleigh. He tucked him in. He read him a Christmas story. He gave him a glass of milk and a cookie. Groundhog curled up in his warm, cozy bed. He closed his eyes. He didn't toss and he didn't turn. And soon he fell asleep. Bring! Groundhog opened one eye. Could you guys do that at home? Can you open just one eye? "It can't be time to get up yet," he grumbled. "I just got to sleep." But his clock says, "February 2nd. Bring! He peered at his clock. "February 2nd. Groundhog yawned and stretched. He tumbled out of his burrow. Snow glittered on the ground. The sun was out. The sky was blue. What do you see? Does anybody know what that is? Groundhog saw his shadow. "What am I doing up?" he said. "There are 6 more weeks of winter coming. I should be in bed." He hurried back inside. He ate a bedtime snack. He read himself a bedtime story. Then he tucked himself into his warm, cozy bed, and he pulled up the covers, closed his eyes, and went to sleep. The end. So do you think Punxsutawney Phil and any other groundhogs who came out to see their shadow went back to sleep today? I wonder. I just want to say a quick hello to some friends who might be watching. Hello to Addie. I saw that you watched last week. And Kinsey, hi. And Kara and Carter and Cade and Cam. I know that the older two probably aren't watching, but I just wanted to give them a shout out too. Hello to Evelyn and Ronan and Joel and Mary and Allie and all my other friends who might be watching today. I hope you're enjoying story time. I wish we could be together doing story time instead of me doing it remotely, but hopefully soon. All right. So we're going to do another little song. So if you guys want to get up and do some wiggling to get your wiggles out, we are going to do, let's see, what can I do sitting down? Let's do the Wheels on the Bus. Oh no, I don't think I have the one that I want on this one. I need my good Wheels on the Bus, the one that is really, really easy to do sitting down. Let's see. Here we go. You guys ready? Can you get your wheels going? And this is Raffi's version of Wheels on the Bus. Let's get our arms going.
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all around the town.
You guys get your wipers ready?
The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish. Swish, 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 swish. The wipers on the bus go swish, 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 all around the town.
Nice job.
The driver on the bus goes move on back, move on back, move on back. The driver on the bus goes move on back, all around the town. people on the bus go up and down, up and down, up and down. People on the bus go up and down, all around the town.
Right, we're gonna do our honking now.
The horn on the bus goes beep, 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 honk, 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 beep, beep, beep. The horn on the bus goes beep, 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 all around the town.
Nice job.
And the baby on the bus goes wah, wah, wah. Baby on the bus goes wah, 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 all around the town. The parents on the bus go shh, 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 shh. The parents on the bus go shh, 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 all around the town.
Nice job, guys. I hope you were all doing those movements at home. All right. We have one more book to read, and this one is called The Grumpy Groundhog. And this one was written by Maureen Wright, illustrated by Amanda Haley, and this is being read with permission from Two Lions Books. The Grumpy Groundhog. I wonder why our groundhog is grumpy. The mayor stood before Groundhog's door and heard a rumbly, rumbly snore. "Groundhog," he said, "you're sleeping late. This is no time to hibernate." The people added with a shout, "It's Groundhog Day, please come out." The mayor pleaded, "I'll ask once more. Won't you open up this door? Please come out and greet your friends. Groundhog Day is here again." "I won't come out," the groundhog said. "I'm closing my eyes and staying in bed." "I have an idea," said a boy in the crowd. He stepped to the front and spoke up loud. "Give him a paper to read in bed." "That's it," said the mayor, nodding his head. Groundhog opened his sleepy eyes. The morning times was a nice surprise. The groundhog took a very long time reading the paper line by line. The people in town said with a shout, "It's Groundhog Day, please come out." The mayor dropped to his knobby knees and begged the groundhog, "Come out, please." "I won't come out," the groundhog said. "I'm staying in here until I am fed." "I know what to do," a little girl said. "Give the groundhog breakfast in bed." They served him food on a fancy tray, coffee and toast and a flower bouquet. Groundhog poured coffee from the pot. "This coffee is good. It's nice and hot." The people in town said with a shout, "It's Groundhog Day, please come out." "I won't come out," the groundhog said. "It's nice and warm in my cozy bed." A girl yelled, "Give him slippers to wear. His bedroom floor is chilly in there." "Of course," said the mayor, "find him a pair. His little tootsies are cold and bare." Groundhog never had slippers before. He did a jig all the way to the door. He twirled and shouted, "Look at me. I'll step outside on the count of three." The crowd yelled, "One, two, three, come out." "Ta-da," he said, looking about. He blinked from the lights and the camera's glare. A child said, "Give him sunglasses to wear." "Hooray," said the mayor, "no shadow today. This chilly weather is going away." The groundhog said, "It's a wonderful day. I'll ask the children if they want to play." "Let's make a snowman," the children cried. Groundhog had fun being outside. They made a snowman round and fat. It looked very nice in the mayor's hat. At the end of the day, the groundhog said, "It's time for me to go back to bed. I had a fun day with all my friends. When spring comes early, I'll see them again." And there he is going back to sleep. So, like I said before, our groundhog saw his shadow today, which means 6 more weeks of winter. Although the groundhog is usually right only about 30% of the time. So who knows what we're gonna have. I hope you enjoyed those stories about Groundhog Day, and I hope you enjoyed today's story time. Our next week, we are gonna be doing penguins and polar bears. So stay tuned for that. If you get a craft kit, those will be ready by this weekend. And other than that, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Take care, everybody. I'll see you soon. Bye.